Hello! Today we are rounding out my trio of videos about where to start with classics with a video that I think is appropriate for kind of two different audiences, and I'll talk about that in just a second, but today we are talking about where to start with children's classics or young readers' classics. And there's two different groups that I'm trying to kind of keep in mind with these recommendations. One is adult or young adult readers who are intimidated by the idea of the classics and want maybe like an easier point of entry than maybe classics that are fully aimed at adults. So as a way to sort of ease into possibly a little bit more archaic language or, you know, different kind of cultural milieus that might be recognizable, or just to get a sense of sort of the canon. And sorry for the quotations, because, you know, all of these things are so subjective, and we could get into a whole video about how the idea of the classics are a little bit, there's pros and cons to even conceptualizing this, but whatever, like, let's leave that to the side for now. Let's just sort of go with the premise that people are interested in maybe some classic books. And this is, I think, a viable route, and something people have mentioned a lot in the comments of the other two videos I've done in this series, that children's classics can be a really approachable way for people to sort of ease into reading older books. The second kind of group I have in mind is maybe adults or young adults who didn't really get into children's classics when they were at the age that these books are aimed at, but kind of are interested in going back and discovering that piece of the received literary tradition that we have, or maybe even they have children of their own and they're interested in sort of like what are maybe some places to start with reading these books along with the people for whom these are aimed at. So I've got a few different kind of types of children's literature I'm going to address. This is gonna be very idiosyncratic to my taste, as always. In some cases, these are books I remember loving at this age and I've either reread or have re-encountered in some way and I feel good about recommending it still. And of course, we're also talking about I am an American, I'm an English speaker, so I'm obviously gonna be focused on recommendations that I would be exposed to by virtue of those two sort of demographic points about me. So I'm sure that there are plenty of children's classics in other languages or in other English-speaking countries even that maybe were not so much on my radar or something I would have encountered as a child or haven't really since. So we're gonna go through a few different categories of typical types of books that are aimed at children. So like animal-focused books, some historical fiction, some other kind of genre fiction aimed at young readers. And really the scope of this is not picture books for the most part, but mostly these will be sort of chapter books or maybe like middle, what we would call middle grade now type reads. So with that being said, maybe let's start with some animal books because there's so many of them and I really enjoyed these as a child, but there's two in particular I want to mention. So like I said, there are so many books aimed at children that involve animals. You know, there's ones that are focused on dogs like Old Yeller. There's, you know, all the different horse ones like the Black Stallion and, you know, it goes on and on and on. For me, there's two in particular that really I remember loving as a child and I have re-encountered since and can still say that I have a lot of affection for. One I'm gonna just mention here briefly because I do think it's a little younger than what this list is mostly aimed at, but I do want to mention that I absolutely love the work of Beatrice Potter as a child. Like, I had these editions and I drew, like, marked them up to crap, loved them, totally ruined these beautiful editions that my mom had gotten me and marked all over them, but they're very charming and I think they have lovely illustrations, many of them, or at least many editions you can get, and I just, as animal books, I just think, you know, The Tales of Peter Rabbit, all of that, it's hard to go wrong with it. But the other one that I decided to pick, The Wind in the Willows was up there. There was a couple of others I was thinking about, but the one that I have read since, and this is the actual copy that I had, I don't know if the little horse drawing that I have in here, but this was the actual copy I had as a child, and that is Black Beauty. This book broke my little heart because it is filled with such highs and lows. And it really, I mean, I remember being very impacted by this as a child in terms of its themes, because it's really about essentially the idea of like how you treat the least of these is the most reflective of who you are as a person. And in this case, the least of these being these animals who we are using in our service. And the movie of this I remember loving as a kid. And I just think that this really holds up in its themes, in its writing. It's the first person narration from the point of view of the animal, which is unusual, I think. Usually it's about the child or the young person who has a relationship with the animal, but this one is really about it's an autobiography basically of this horse. And it's the one that I recommend. I think it really, like I said, I think it really holds up and it's my favorite of all the sort of animal themed children's classics. Next, let's go with sort of coming of age stories, which again, there is a lot of this in children's literature. And I'm gonna recommend two different kinds, one aimed aimed squarely at children. The other truth of the matter, though, is that there is a lot of coming of age stories that are not technically children's literature, but do tend to get read by children and feature young people as their protagonists. So I'll mention a few of those as well as my like actual real recommendation. But this is actually the book that made me a reader and made me a classics reader. I read this, I think, when I was 6 or 7, and I didn't realize it was a children's classic. I just thought it was a classic. And so this is what like really emboldened me to start reading things like Dickens and Jane Austen and all of them, because it gave me a lot of confidence basically as a young reader. But Heidi is definitely my favorite coming of age story I've ever read and has such a special place in my heart to this day. It is about a little girl who is an orphan, and she is eventually sent to live with her grandpa in the Swiss Alps. This is, I think, maybe one of the best known kind of pieces of literature that Switzerland has ever produced. I think it's something that is known worldwide. Anyway, this is beautiful in terms of its description of the Swiss Alps and sort of like pastoral life there. Heidi herself is just incredibly lovable. She's eventually sent to be a companion to this young girl who is an invalid, and that whole piece of it is very lovely. And really, this is just about like how the simplicity of this like simple life is sometimes the best life. And I don't know, it's just beautiful. I loved it. So this is my favorite coming of age classic that I think is actually aimed at children. But there's actually a lot of coming of age stories that are either aimed at adults. So like The Catcher in the Rye, I would say is aimed at adults, but is about a teenager. Basically the whole Bildungs Roman tradition. So I think Anne of Green Gables, I would probably characterize as some version of YA. I remember liking this, but not loving it, though I know it is beloved. And then Little Women is often cited as a children's classic, and it is a coming of age story. I don't really think of this as squarely aimed at children, but like it is another, I think, very well-loved coming of age pick. But the one that I want to recommend is I Capture the Castle by Dodie Smith. And again, I would probably describe this as intended to be somewhat YA in the time it was written. It's kind of hard to say, but I do absolutely think that this is such a charming story. Our protagonist is maybe like one of the most charismatic main characters I've ever read in a story. And it really is just a simple kind of tale of this girl who is living in what is, I think, usually described as like genteel poverty in this like remote English castle, and basically just about how her kind of coming into adulthood, love lost and maybe won, and just her really understanding and finding her place in the world. So I think that this is an underrepresented, underloved classic of coming of age literature. It's such a charming, just sort of Bildungs Roman. It's not that this is obscure, but I think that this doesn't get praised enough as just like great example of coming of age. And like the writing in this, I just think is absolutely lovely. So I think this is set in sort of like 30s or 40s, maybe the 50s, but it's a modern classic and it's absolutely lovely. And then moving into what I would describe as genre classics. And I should mention at this point, I'm kind of including both sort of, I usually think of classics as being 1950 and before, and then sort of modern classics as being roughly like 1950 to, I don't know, like 1990-ish. Noted here that I'm including some more recent entries into the children's classic canon. So just take that. I decided I didn't want to break that into two, like where to start with classics and where to start with modern classics for children. So I'm combining it all here. But anyway, all that to say, I have a couple of genre picks. So sci-fi fantasy. Sci-fi wise, I definitely think A Wrinkle in Time by Madeleine L'Engle is the one that I would most recommend as a children's classic of sort of sci-fi literature. Again, I think that this is one that just, it speaks to children, but it is so beautifully written and so powerful in its themes and evocative in its sort of imagery that it speaks to adults too. So this is one that I definitely think if you're trying to get into, I guess, modern classics at least of sci-fi literature, I mean, this one I think you really can't go wrong with. And then in terms of fantasy, I would say The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe from C.S. Lewis. The whole Narnia series, I think, is just a wonderful children's fantasy classic. Again, thematically, you know, he has a very specific philosophical worldview that will or won't jive with some people, but I think there's still a lot of, I think, universal themes in here. Incredibly memorable characters, really a defining series in terms of fantasy as a whole and where it's gone, especially within portal fantasy. So I think it is a children's classic, but really this is just a fantasy classic. And I think a great place to start if you're looking for some fantasy from the 40s that has some talking lions and white witchy winter ladies. This will do ya. A mystery classic that I wanted to mention for children that I absolutely love and I think is still pretty well loved but should have more people into it, and that is The Westing Game by Ellen Raskin. This is a game about people trying to get an inheritance. They all live in the same building, and if you are a lover of mystery and you've never picked this up, this is a great children's classic version of it. I would call this probably middle grade, and it's written, I think it's from the 70s, so it has a pretty good like 70s city vibe to it that's really fun. And this is one of the books that really made me concretize that I love mysteries. So one that I definitely have a lot of affection for, and it's definitely to me the first thing that comes to mind when I think of children's classic mystery, modern classic at least, because mystery is also one that I think in terms of like Sherlock Holmes short stories, that's a great place if you're trying to get your kid into reading classics, or just if you're trying to get into classics in general, Sherlock Holmes short stories are a great way to go. I think those are fun for all ages, but in terms of something aimed at children, The Westing Game is what comes to mind. And then I do want to give, as my last kind of genre area, two of the historical fiction children's classics that I love. One of them is from the 40s and one of them is from the 80s. So the one from the 40s is Johnny Tremaine by, I believe, Esther Forbes. And this is I would describe this probably as middle grade, and it is about this young silversmith apprentice in the American Revolutionary War period. The opening is him working with his master on trying to create this platter for John Hancock. A whole journey unfolds from there, but it is really fascinating because it's a 1940s children's approach to talking about the American Revolution. So the sort of like history nerd in me loves seeing kind of how that period of history was viewed in the 40s versus how that book might have been written today. But anyway, all that to say, I personally really love that book, and I remember when we read, that was one that I read with through school, and I remember all of us really enjoying that one, and I reread it once, I think, in my 20s and still had a lot of fondness for it. It's also a pretty fun movie adaptation. But anyway, so Johnny Tremaine is where I would go for kind of a true classic of historical fiction for children, and then a modern classic, and to my mind, it's my favorite bit of children's literature about the Holocaust or about World War II. I absolutely love this book, and I feel like it's overshadowed by another book from this author, and that is Number of the Stars from Lois Lowry. I think everybody remembers The Giver, which is another great choice if you're thinking of sort of modern classic for sci-fi, but I, you know, kind of a children's dystopian classic. But Number of the Stars is a beautiful story about this young girl who lives in Holland and her family's efforts to resist Nazi occupation and help friends who are Jewish escape to freedom in Sweden. And I love that book. I read, again, another one that I feel like I reread probably in my 20s. I reread that probably 6 or 7 years ago, and I remember really enjoying it on the reread. And as a child, I read it many times because I just absolutely loved it. And again, in terms of talking about that period of history, it is definitely my favorite kind of children's classic addressing that period of modern history. So that rounds out my picks for places you could start for children's classics. There's so many different places you could start. I mean, I didn't even talk about like Pippi Longstocking or, you know, adventure type things like The Hatchet or Call of the Wild. You know, Jules Verne is aimed at adults, but I think is read by a lot of children for classics. So like you could go there. You could go to The Secret Garden or A Little Princess. Like there's so many. We have an embarrassment of riches of classic children's literature. These are just some ones that really connected to me as a child, or I kind of feel like I can co-sign them as an adult. But definitely let me know if you are trying to help somebody pick a children's classic to help them either get into classics writ large or to kind of explore the children's classic canon. Definitely let me know your recommendations of where you would send somebody down in the comments below. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this last entry into the Where to Start with Classics series I've been doing. I think I am now going to transition into sort of like 201 classics. So look for that in the coming year of, okay, you've kind of gotten your feet wet with classics and now you're ready to sort of maybe move on to things that are possibly a little more difficult or less approachable, but are still really worth the read. So look for that sometime in 2021. But yeah, I think that will do it for me for now. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, follow me on the social medias if you are so inclined. I have all that information listed in the description box below, and I think that that will do it. I hope you are having an absolutely lovely day today, and I will just talk to you soon. Bye.